We're back in the saddle. Hello, Coach Miller Lite here. Cinnamon here with us again today. We
Much
have
love.
a dynamic topic today, a topic that is absolutely rocking my world. Continuing on with the teachings of Abraham, this is the track, a five-minuter. This is a big one on relationships and agreements. Is it ever life-altering? My life has been altered by this today. Cinnamon.
Yes. Wow, that's big news. That's another sign of alignment, Mayor.
Right.
So let's just get right to So, relationships and agreements. I have come forth to be creator, to set forth my thought and emotion in order to draw unto me. I am here with others because I am also wanting to be co-creator. I am first and foremost individual creator, and sometimes upon some topics, I am co-creator. Most relationships are better in the beginning than they are later. Because in the beginning, I am focused upon what I am wanting to see. And by law of attraction, I'm soliciting more of that. As time goes by, because most of us do not understand the law of attraction, we begin to look also for things that we do not want and begin to solicit more and more of those. Sometimes, until I become part of a relationship that is not to my liking, I am not really clear on what I do like. It is a value to live in a house that does not have enough closets to identify that I am wanting more closets.
Right.
In
Great.
the physical world, because so many are not understanding the laws, most do not believe they can have everything exactly as they are wanting. We say, I cannot have everything perfect, so I must put up with this I do not want. And so we attract relationships that satisfy some of our intentions, but not others. Later, only to discover that those other intentions were very important to me, and the lack of having them satisfied leaves me feeling empty. It's about fine-tuning, is what I'm understanding here, understanding the laws and knowing I can have it all due to the law of attraction. I
Right.
am creator and I can have it all.
Right. Knowing how it goes.
Right.
One of the solutions. That's what I got today. I have these, what was the heart of what I got? Well, the first thing I have to know is I am first creator and second co-creator.
Right.
Understand that other people being involved in my creation, that's the secondary thing. And that the reason I'm here with other people is because that's part of what I came to do. That's why there's other people came to create and co-create and let others in that co-creation, let others be who they are. That they're not all to be like me. They're not all to wish as I wish, choose as I choose, be as I am, desire as I do. Let the diversity be, let others be. And then farm my own land, mind my
Always.
business. What's that?
Always.
Right. Then what else? Then what's the next? First thing goes wrong. Well, we don't get it that first we're here to create and second to co-create, let others be who they are. Second, we farm their land. They go better in the beginning because in the beginning, I'm looking at what I would like. It's so well said. Abraham just like mapped it out. It seems like 5 minutes is long for a track because it's kind of one of the longer tracks in the intro,
Yeah.
but it's so condensed. It's like this is the answer to having good relationship, meaning, and Abraham made it clear that they're talking student teacher, mates coming together, parents, siblings, any relationship, two or more creators. That's what they're talking about. That's co-creation. That's what they're considering relationship. So mind my own business, farm my own land, because in the beginning I'm thinking about all the things I like about the other person because it's easy to. And then as time goes on, because of not knowing the law, then I start to think about things I do not like in the other person and solicit those. And then the relationship ends up not going good only because I put that person through the lemon squeezer. In my mind, the mind, it's this machinery and it always does the same thing. It wrings them out. And
Yep.
I'm learning, Cinnamon. I'm learning it. I'm learning it through experience. I'm learning it through wringing people out in my mind. and being like, what happened? I rang them. I thought about them. I let myself think about them. And now law of attraction is responding. And the thoughts sometimes seem good, but man, that system in there, if it goes in, even if it seems good, it ends up squirting out the other end, a rind. And it was this big, nice, juicy fruit.
Right? Yeah, chew them up and spit them out.
Literally. Cinnamon is so funny. Yes.
And I'm remembering that I have come forth to identify moment by moment, segment by segment, day by day, year by year, what it is I am wanting. And to stay focused on that, to use the power of my thought to focus upon it and utilize the power of the law of attraction to draw it unto me.
Yes.
And I'm doing this whether I'm realizing it or not. I'm doing it if I'm sucking the deliciousness or if I'm chewing them up and spitting them out. This is happening. This is what is going on. And it's so helpful to know.
Yes.
Helpful to remember. And I appreciate you, Mary, because without this, I wouldn't be, without you, I wouldn't be doing this. And we've had a couple days off and I noticed that I'm not as good when I'm not doing this.
I know, right?
Thank you, Goddess, for Mary calling forth this call for today, because it's for me and I could really use it. I choose to understand this. I choose to remember this. I choose to have successful, happy, productive relationships. And it's through the laws that I'm going to have this.
Right.
I bless you. I thank you. So beautiful there with the Q on your shirt.
All right.
Queen of Hearts. Oh, Queen of Hearts.
What's that?
That's who I choose to co-create with.
Right.
The Queen of Hearts.
Well, when I am is when I know how it goes, which is why to really delve into the study. You know, I was very thankful today for this 5-minute passage because it took a good bit of time to write this. And I've heard it many times and I had an idea of what Abraham was going to say, but I just heard it different today. The third thing I have as in my like four main things I got out of this is what you just already said is know how it goes. Because isn't it an interesting point they make that because most don't know how it goes, myself included. Sometimes I do. Sometimes I demonstrate my knowing. I'm coming on it. I'm getting in the game. I'm understanding it, but I don't always act like it. So temporarily, right? It's coming, but knowing how it goes, then I know that I can have everything. And then when I know I can have everything, I won't settle for less than what I really would like. And that will help the relationships in my life. And another part of it, which is perfection in the process. Sometimes it's a benefit to be part of a house with not enough closets to know I'm wanting more closets. So even in the process where I don't know how the universe works and I don't know that I'm actually creating people the way they are. And then in the beginning, it's good because I think the thoughts. And then as it goes, I start to munch them in my mind and look at what I don't like. And then they become like that because of universal law, because law of attraction is responding to that vibration and manifesting them that way in my experience. Even during that, it's perfect because I'm launching the desire for what it is I do choose. I'm becoming clearer in my intention, which was the last thing on here is about the launch and creations together, which I think is such a cool point.
Yes. You know,
like the points that Abraham makes on relationships really are rocking my world. I'm like, should this be a 2-part call? Because this is so big. Yet there's so much more to come. So we'll keep it to one for now, but it really is all one topic about the launching creations together. I really enjoy this part of how as people, we tend to have an idea. And I love the way they say it. It all starts with a little thought, right? This is how creation starts, a little thought. And then the little thought grows. And next thing you know, there's this emotional release with it. And it's literally a launching of creation. And then I'm like, oh, I'm so excited. And I go to the other and I say, okay, this is my idea and this is your part. And then they're not always as excited because they weren't part of the launching. And Abraham just really rocks my world on how they say this, that if you're not part of the launching of it, that emotional release, you're not going to be excited about the action unless my desire to please the other person is predominant. And that's what I care about more than following what I really want to do. So if I can help, we can co-create. They said, if we communicate more fully with each other,
yes,
right? Not an easy thing to do, but it could be. If we can communicate more fully, then we can launch more of our creations together, and then we can be in joyful action. So when I look at my life and I'm like, well, I don't do that much, right? Like, I'm much more imposing my will, imposing what I would like on the other. And I'm excited to really start to try to do this, make this my strategy, understand that others won't do their action in joy unless they have been part of the launching of the creation. That and Abraham says they shouldn't do it. We should never do action that's not in joy. Now, of course, that's far different than the way we mostly live, but that doesn't mean that we can't live that way. Anything on this, Cinnamon? Any feedback from you? I love your feedback. I know you're living this and studying it. I'm like, this is gonna be great, right? I mean, this is such a big topic.
And well, yeah, that explains.
I never talked to it about.
It explains a lot, because when I have a great idea and I'm super excited about it, that the others aren't as excited about it because they weren't a part of the launching of the idea.
Right. Yes.
I was like, oh, this is a fantastic idea. Why are you not as excited as I am?
Yeah.
And so now I understand and I know that.
Right. Right.
And most of my reality and my world is involving other people.
Yeah.
And so it's good to know and understand this, because I want there to be action and joy.
Right. Yes. Woo.
Yes. I'm choosing to feel good. I'm choosing to be co-creator, and I'm choosing to launch these rockets of desire with the others, so yeah, they can be just as excited as I am about it.
Yes.
So they'll be in on the plan.
They'll be in on the plan. It's exciting. It fires me up. I feel like I've been around people a lot lately, and you know, more time around people, it seems like, and I'm very excited to understand how to co-create in harmony. And here it is. It's laid out here. So, well, we've gone way over, but you know, sometimes you do. So I'm going to go with, this is the perfect amount of time, because I could still keep on talking about this topic. It's fantastic. And of course, we'll talk about it again, because it is the only topic. It's knowing how it goes is the basis of it. So now I'll have opportunity to practice, and that I shall do.
And I love how they said there's great love for us.
Right.
It helps remember that we're loved. That love is the answer, and that there is love for us.
Yes.
And that we're doing great. We're cherished. We're loved. We're revered. They're rooting for us.
Yes.
They're cheering us on. They want us to understand these laws. They want us to understand how to have successful relationships and launch rockets of desire together and have joy.
Oh, when you do that. Watching them, baby. Oh, it's a joy to be here with you, Cinnamon.
I love you, Mare.
Oh, I love you too. Until next time, our YouTube friends, stay tuned.
And stay connected.
Staying aligned, staying aligned. Oh, 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 oh. Staying aligned, staying aligned. Oh, 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 oh.